Now I want to describe a family of strategies that I'm calling hold at n, where n is an integer. For example, hold at 20 is the strategy that keeps on rolling until the pending score is greater or equal to 20, and then it holds. And the point of this strategy is you get points by rolling, but you risk points by rolling as well. And the higher the pending score is, the more you're risking. So there should be some point at which you're saying, that's too much of a risk. I've accumulated so much pending that I don't want to risk anymore, and then I'm going to hold. So hold at 10, hold at 20, hold at 30 describes that family of strategies. And I should say there's one subtlety here that we'll build in to hold at, which is, let's say that the goal is 50, and my score when I start my round is, say, 40. And then let's say I roll a 6 and a 4. Now, according to hold at 20, I should keep on rolling because my pending score is only 10. I haven't gotten up to 20 yet. But it would be silly for me to keep rolling at that point because I would risk pigging out and only scoring 1 point and getting to 41. Whereas I know if I hold now, I have 40 plus 6 plus 4 is 50. I've already won the game. So hold at 20 will hold when pending is greater than or equal to 20, or when you win by holding. So I want you to go ahead and implement that. And since hold at x is a whole family of strategy functions, hold at x is not going to be a strategy function. Rather, it's going to return a strategy function. And so I've given you this outline of saying we're going to define a strategy function, then we're going to fix up its name a little bit to describe it better, and then we're going to return it. And you have to write the code within the strategy function. And I should say, we're going to stick with the representations of states, where a state is a four-tuple of the player to move, 0 or 1, me and you score, and the pending score.